Even slippers.
Hey, so today when you guys are on your phones, when you pick up your phone this morning, the cell phone is 40 years old today.
Aww. Oh, that is
crazy. I didn't realize it was that old.
Years
ago
no,
today.
Can't be.
I didn't realize it was that old.
40 years
we
ago
had
today.
One of these when I was growing
perhaps
up.
The most important phone call was ever made, and it was on one of those, on a that big brick looking thing.
And, whoa, Motorola.
I remember Southwestern Bell.
I love Southwestern
Bell. I do remember that. Do you remember the phones that used to at your house when you would dial and it would
the rotary phones?
And then shoop. And then if you messed up a number, you had to start all over again.
We had a phone in a bag, too. Like, it was in a bag, and you could, like, charge it. And then, like, my mom would sit in the football games, and she had this, like, bag that had a huge phone inside it. And then she'd put it, like, the console in the middle of the car.
Do you remember the phone where you went? Operator,
Susie, we don't remember
it's
that.
So
phone.
Interesting.
No, because I never met Edison Bell.
Isn't it interesting the way that technology has changed
Edison
over the years?
Bell.
Edison Bell, Thomas Edison. I know, I can't.
I tried to play it off.
It just distracted me. I just can't.
You know, I thought it would be so funny though for my kids, you know, to take everything in our house and put it back to the way that it was, you know, 40 years ago.
Right.
Do the rotary phone, no cell phones, black and white television, you know, the whole thing, and watch them freak out.
No, they would freak out.
I don't think they would know how to handle everything.
I know, but they'd have fun.
Yeah.
At first, they really would. They'd be laughing a lot.
Get an eight-track player.
That's and we can wear vintage clothing.
I think it would be fun just to turn them loose in the yard where there was nothing but grass and a tree.
See, and that's what I used to do.
Stay out there and play.
Mm-hmm. I used to do that, just play outside.
And that's what we did. We played in the yard and we pretended. It was great fun.
You know, I'll tell you, having boys, I think boys maybe are more prone to, you know, playing outside and doing that kind of thing maybe than girls are. Or maybe I'm going to get in trouble for saying that.
I was going to say, because I was outside. I had my fifth wheel, and I would drive that thing up and down the driveway by myself. I mean,
I was
running around chasing birds.
But it's fun to watch the boys now. So in this new house that we have the creek in the back. Mm-hmm. And they're, you know, of course, it's been raining the last couple days. But a couple days ago, they were down at the creek, and they're catching little lizards, and they're all muddy. And just the way that should
be. I mean, I used to do all that. I grew up in the country, though. So
I never played in outside. I didn't like the way that the air would make me, like, I would come inside, my mom would be like, do you know how to play outside? And I'm like, I don't like the way the air smells outside.
You smell like a little puppy.
You smell like air. Like,
you know what's funny?
Like a sweaty kindergartner.